regression testing. I want to execute only sanity testing and a smoke testing. So how to do this? So we have a concept called grouping execution. Okay, how to group the test cases? We have 100 test cases. Inside this we have a some test cases are regression, sanity testing, smoke testing. So I want to skip the sanity testing. I don't want to execute the sanity testing. Yeah, only I want to execute the sanity testing. So in this condition, we can do by grouping execution. So how to group the test cases? So what happened? This is the concept of grouping. How to group the test cases in Selenium? For example, we have a 200 test cases. Out of this, some are in testing test cases, some are regression testing, functional testing, smoke testing test cases. So if don't categorize these test cases, for all the test cases will come under the one common category. So for grouping in Selenium, we have to use test engine feature. So and we can achieve create a group and maintain the dynamic. Okay. So how to do that? We have a include and exclude group. By using this include and exclude, we can include and we can exclude. So that means we can skip the test cases. Okay. So how to perform this? So how to create the group? So we have a predefined syntax. So at direct test, inside this we have a group and this curly braces, here the group name. So this is the syntax of the grouping. How to group this? For example, in the syntax of this group name, for example, at direct test groups equal to, this is the smoke testing. Okay. So by using in the test engine class, we can perform this grouping. So we can also create the multiple group. How to do this? This is the syntax of multiple group. So groups equal to curly braces. That is, we can pass the group 1, group 2, like sanity testing, smoke testing, like that. So after grouping in Selenium, we can specify the include and exclude in the XML file. So what is the meaning of include and exclude? Include means it tells testng.xml that which group we need to execute. Include means. Exclude means it tell to testng.xml file which group we have to skip. I don't want to execute regression testing, then we will put on the exclude. I want to execute sanity testing and smoke testing, I will give the include. So this is your test cases. We have test script, we have created this to test group. So we have a test group here. This one. So in this testng class, this is the class name test group. So you can see here we have a smoke. I took as a smoke. So inside this smoke we have a login page. So this is the one test cases and this is the only smoke test cases. Okay, a smoke scenario. Again we took the regression. So we have a register page. Inside this regression we have a registration like test cases, like we are doing the some validation of registration page. Okay, again we have a smoke. Inside this smoke another test cases is there, log on test cases. Okay, we have one sanity testing. Sanity testing means re-logging page. I am going to validate. So these are how to create the group stuff inside this testng class. Okay. So now how to do with XML file, because I have to group with XML file, right? So this is executing using the XML file. So how will you do this? So we have a this file is this one. this XML file, so this is by default is coming. Okay, this is stuff. So here you can see this is the in interview they will ask, can you write the group execution, you know, grouping execution. What is the grouping execution? Don't tell only definition, you have to write this code. So you can see here, after test, this test name, we have a group tag. Now I close this group tag here, right? Okay, I close this group tag. You can see this is here, the grouping is starting from here to here. Group tag, after that it will come run. Okay, again here it is closed, right? This inside this, so simply we have to remember, first it will come the group tag. Okay, it started here, it ended here. Inside this we have a run tag, it's started here and it's end here, right? Inside this we can write include and exclude. Okay, so you can see here include name equal to I took a smoke. Okay, don't, you have to write same name. Okay, this one, if you will write wrong, you will get error. So you have to write same whatever you have passed inside this, in this XML file. Okay, so where is this XML file? This one. Okay, so you can see this is commented. Okay, I have commented now. This is the how to comment this XML tag. Okay, so by using this you can comment this. Okay, so I'm not using right now. Okay, include means we are going to execute a smoke testing. Exclude means we are going to skip regression testing. Again included. So include means I'm again going to execute sanity testing, right? So this is your tag, you have to remember. If you will go in the interview, half of the company might be having the written paper. So they will ask what is the grouping execution, because a lot of the crowd in the interview, right? So if you have a anything, any topic in Selenium or Java, write code first, then write theory. Okay, nobody will reject you in written and technical stuff. When you will apply this, write code first, then write, tell the theory. Okay, if the interviewer will not tell you to write the code, you have to write yourself. And if you will go in the any interview, keep one pen and paper in your hand always, because sometimes they don't have any pen and paper, the interviewer, right? They will not arrange suddenly because they don't have a time. Keep one blank paper and pen always when you are going for the interview. So better to write the code, it's very good habit. Okay, so this is, after that you can see we have used this classes, right? Okay, this tag. So first what you have to remember, after this the group will start and here it will end. Okay, inside this we have a run tag. Okay, after that here close, and inside this we can write this. Okay, so now I'm going to execute this. I'm going to execute by class. Okay, one class. So you can see we have a smoke test cases, regression, a smoke, sanity. So if I am going to execute this, so inside this what I skipped here, regression, I skipped here, right? Regression. So here regression will not execute. We'll go through this. So you can see here a smoke testing is passed. A smoke testing is passed. Sanity testing, regression done. You can see it is coming 4, right? This a smoke is sanity. Oh, okay. Actually here why it is executed, it should not execute. where I put it down here. Oh, sorry. One again regression is there, okay. Actually, I did not comment at this because the regression is also executing. So here we are executing all. Okay, this is commented. Okay, so we are also executing regression, sanity and a smoke in this case. Okay, so that's why it is executing all four test cases. Okay, so now if I will comment this, uncomment this. Okay, so what I'm going to do, this is exclude, right? Both I have to take exclude, okay? I'm going to do. Okay, now I did exclude. Okay, sanity I did exclude, right? Hey, this is the include only, but okay, let's see. Include means it will execute. So how many test cases I think it will execute all, right? So it is executing all, but I want to should not execute. Should be a skip, right? It is not a skip. This one. Okay, I commented this include, exclude, and this. Now I'm going to execute this. Here you can see we have a three test cases executing, right? I exclude this regression, so regression is not going to execute here. So here it skips the regression testing. Understood, right? So this is called your grouping execution. Do you have any doubt regarding this? Include, exclude. Shall I go ahead?
Yes.
Okay, so this is called grouping execution. So you have to remember the syntax, how to do this grouping and XML. Okay, so this is called your grouping execution. Next concept is called cross-border testing. Cross-border testing means you have a Mac. So in Mac, Safari browser is by default is there, right? So what happened when the people are using Mac system, definitely they will use the Safari. I'm using Windows, okay? So frequently the people are using Chrome and Firefox and Internet Explorer. So what is the meaning of cross browser testing means? I have created one application and client requirement is you have to test this application for all browsers. Like all the browsers. Okay, so what happened? Sometime Chrome, Firefox, yeah, whatever you are using this. So every month the new version is coming, right? So again you have to execute because we will test our application is working in the new version or not. So how will you do this? So what happened? If I will execute one time, my application will run all the, like Facebook. So I want to test the Facebook application. So what you have to write the code. If I will execute my script, It will open in the Chrome, then close it. It will open in the Firefox, close it. It will open in the Internet Explorer, close it. It will open in the Safari, close it. It will open in the Opera, close it. So this is called your cross-browser testing. So cross-browser testing is a type of functional test to check that your web application work as expected in the different browsers. Okay. Why we do this cross-browser testing? So Weston application are totally different from the window application, right? Web application, okay? So a web application can be open in the any browser by end users, or some prefer to open like the Facebook in the different browser, while others can be used in the Chrome or IE. Okay? How to create this cross-browser testing? So we'll discuss this code later. We have a small piece of the code for the cross-browser testing. Okay? So we have to create one class. Okay. So this is your class browser. So what you have to do here? What we are going to do here? Just we have write the simple logic here. Okay. So we have this class name cross browser, and I took one variable. I took why this variable I took as a class level, because we have to use this variable in the another place also. If you will not take as a class level, then you can't use everywhere, right? This variable. So that's why WebDriver I took as a variable, as a class name. So execution is starting from where? Add a test. So now I'm not going to discuss this parameter. I will come on this. Okay. So add a test inside this one method should be there. So test. I'm passing one parameter here, a string browser. I will put on this condition. Okay, so one condition is else condition. So what happened? Browser dot equal ignore case dot Chrome. Then I have written this how to launch this browser, right? How to launch this browser? System dot set property. We can pass this key value there, right? Again, I have created the Chrome driver. You can write WebDriver driver also here. No problem at all. Why? But why we will write again and again web driver? So that's why I took this variable as a class name. What I'm going to do? Again, I'm launching this Facebook here, and I'm going to quit this browser. Okay. This is one condition. It will launch with Chrome. What is the use of else if? What is the use of else if condition?
For true or false, this condition it's not executing means this one it will execute.
Yes, if it this condition will not satisfy,
yeah,
then this will execute.
Yeah.
Okay. So it will, you know, like if you have a one just type IE browser, right? So you can say same condition I apply with here, right? Same, but I am going to execute with Internet Explorer. So same thing, you have to, you know, use this Internet Explorer.
If we want more means, we can use some more else if also, right?
Yes, yes, else if. You can make it the 10 also. No problem at all. Okay? This. Okay? So same, you have to apply with same. Just you have to pass the parameter. Again, I did same, right? Same steps I have written, just launching this Facebook. This is your class, but you have to write the some code with the XML file also. So now this XML file, what you have to do? So when you will create this XML file, after test we have to write this parameter. Okay, so parameter name is browser and value is Chrome. So you can see this parameter name we have to pass here. Where it is? This one. Okay, so here a direct parameter browser. So that's why I did not discuss at that time. This a direct parameter, this name must be same whatever the name you have passed here. Value I took Chrome here. Okay, here parameter name and value equal to Chrome. So here you can see this class name and this. Then we will make it by default, it will come. Then you have to edit this. Okay. So you can see this com dot this. Again, this is completed. Again, you can see the test name. I took test name. You can take anything. No issue at all. Again, you can see same stuff. I can apply here, right? Again. So how many here browser is there? Only two browser is there. So you can see the name must be same. Whatever you are passing in the parameter and value I. So whatever the value you have passed here, this one is comparing from here. So how this condition is checking? This browser's equal to, it will checking from in this here. The value is checking from here. So this name, value name and this browser name must be same when you are writing this code on this testing class. Okay, so again same, you have just copy paste, that's it. Okay, so just you have to do the practice one and two times, you are able to remember this tag. So same thing, someone will ask what is the cross browser testing, then you have to write the XML code and you have to write this code also. So if you are able to understand, you can write easy. If you are not able to understand, you are not able to write, but you know Java, then I think it is very simple, right? So this is called cross browser testing. I am going to execute this. I took only two browser, you can take multiple browser and just you can do this copy paste all this one also. Okay, and you can do this copy paste also same. If you are, I have one more code of this, I will show you. So this is Internet Explorer is executing now, you can see here. Internet Explorer and this is your Chrome browser is executing. So both browser is, you can see, executing. You can make it the multiple, like 10 browser is there, same you have to do, just copy paste and just same thing. In TestNG class, what you have to do, FLS condition you have to write how many browsers you are.
But other functions or other features also we can do same page only, means not only login, inside so many features will be there, no? So that one also I can write same this URI cross browser dot java way, or I want to create another class also.
You want to execute the test cases also, like right test steps. What you are asking? Sorry.
You are here only browser only you are launching, right? But I want to execute every feature, each and every features also. I can write same in this cross browser dot java. I can write everything, or I want to create some other class.
No. We'll go with the framework. I will explain you.
Okay. Framework, not framework is different. No, this is.
Okay. I'll tell you. What you are telling.
Okay. Because in cross browser, this is also we can use a screenshot and extend report, and how to send mail. That is also everything we can do, right?
Yes. This is one more code I am going to explain. Okay. So okay. You can. This is your one test cases.
Okay.
Right. You are telling like that.
Yeah.
Again. You
yeah.
You can write again another test cases. Whatever the test cases. You
can same in this class I can write each and every features also.
Yes, you can use the multiple, you can write the multiple test.
Then what about a screenshot and extend report that and all?
Means what you want to include this?
You want to create separate class or here I can
you can do here also. Yeah, you can create a separate class and just call this call. And what you have to do? Create one separate class and create one method. Inside this method, you can write the logic of this screenshot, and okay. inside this just create a object of this and call this class. Understood, okay. right? Call this method.
Okay. So I okay.
Understood, right?
In this page, repeat again.
What you have to do? One generic package is there, right? Generic package.
Yeah.
Inside this generic package, you are added the features of the test. Okay, you want to add the extend report. You want to add the screenshot.
Okay. That is separate. Okay, package. Yeah. Okay. Then that package I want to call here. Right?
Yes. Yeah. You can call inside this.
One method I want to create inside everything.
No, you have right. to create an object, right?
Okay.
Then by using this, just call this method. Understood, right?
Okay. Yeah.
So this is the simple, okay, cross browser. So we can enhance this code also, okay? Because why I have to this simple? Because of understanding. So we can enhance this, okay? Not a big deal. So you can.
Then what is listener?
Sorry.
Listener.
By using the listener, we have a multiple features. You can use the listener for the creating and report also. We have a multiple stuff is there inside this listener. Okay, like 10 to 15 methods are there inside this listener. But listener, they have created to create a report and all. Mainly,
yeah.
But now different stuff is coming, extended report and.
Okay. Because automation means we can do everything, right? So after execution, automatically mail sent through.
Okay. What I have to do, 80% to 85% or 90%, I have completed the selection. But 10% or more than 10% and 100 to 120%, you can make it yourself. Okay, in the Google, lot of the things is there.
No. Actually, I'm asking just.
No problem. Actually, what I have to. Actually, the people where is stuck in Selenium because of they don't have a knowledge of core Java. Okay. You will search on the Google, you will get code, all the code on Google. But now you are able to understand the code, you can execute the code on your system. The same thing you have to do in the company, right?
Okay.
So main thing is understanding the Java. If you don't know Java concept, then it looks like, oh my God, what is this? So if you will go in this framework, the people doesn't know Java. I have a one simple framework, so I'm not getting time to enhance this and all, but I will explain one framework. If I will tell these packages, the people doesn't know Java, oh my God, what is this? Okay, if in this package we have a multiple classes, right? So if you don't know Java, then what happens? It will bounce. So that's why I am spending too much on the core Java. Okay, so core Java is important. If you know the Java, then you can learn any technology. Because every technology is based on the OOPS concept right now, okay? OOP concept.
Yeah.
You guys are learning Python. You can see after a few days, you will say, oh, what is this Python? Okay, so like that only. So core Java is the base of, OOP concept. Coding, logical coding, there is no need in of the logical coding. It depends upon you. If you are getting the time, make the functionality. Like, you can take any code and try to make your logic. One time, two time, three time, four time. I have tried 15 times. So what happened? In your mind, 15 logic is created. Still your code is not working. Leave it. At least you have a knowledge of 15 logic, right? So if you will do the another code, might be some 15 logic will tie up with this logic. So like that, you will enhance your logical coding. So before class, you can see same, this is the only cross browser testing, okay? So just I enhance this code. You can, if you will type in the Google, you will get different type of the code, but same thing, they can, concept is the same only. If you will type in the Google, the same code will come, concept is same, cross browser testing, okay? So this is the before class means I already discussed before class, right? It will execute only once before all the test cases is executing. So I took inside this, you know, before class. So same thing inside this, I have took same, you know, whatever the code I had discussed, so same I did here, right? I have created one setup method and I took this parameter again. Again I put one condition equals Firefox. So here I have added one Firefox also, but this code is not, this Firefox is not working in my system. I did not change this. You guys will fix out this, okay? So let's see. So I took, you can see one condition, again else if condition. Here I am taking the Chrome browser. Again I took else if condition. So I might be some more browser is there, then you can just copy paste and make it like that. Okay, I took one else block. If nothing will execute, then what will happen, you know, browser is not correct, okay? Inside this I took one test cases, so you can take here multiple test cases, no problem at all. So I took one test cases, Facebook is launching, I'm entering this email and password, again email and email ID and password here. That's it. This is my test cases. So you can take the multiple test cases, you can make it here, you can add the another steps also here. And after class just I am going to quit this browser, all the stuff, okay? So let's I will go in this XML file, okay? So here you can see I use this parallel equal to tests, not using this. I will come on this. What is the meaning of parallel? Okay. What is the meaning of parallel? Okay. I will come on this. Okay. So leave it this. It's not required. Okay. Now I will explain this. What is the meaning of parallel? So leave it this. So you can see same I am going to do here. Chrome test. Parameter I am passing this browser here. Where is this test cases? This one, right? This one. So parameter, you can see this is the small browser I am passing. So same thing I am passing here. Okay, again you can see this classes, again this class name, it will come by default. So you have to make it this. Again you can see the you can test name, you can take anything, no issue at all, but parameters and value you have to give same, whatever the given in the test ng class. Okay, so you can see I took for I test. So here we are working with three browsers. Might be this Firefox is not working in my system. Try to fix in yourself. Okay, let's execute this.
This one by one execute. Parallel means at a time every browser it will execute,
yes,
right?
Yes, 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 yes. Code is same, but I have to modify here. Okay.
Yeah. Parallel. Yeah. If you are given three times means.
You have to. I have given none, so it is called only cross browser testing.
Yeah.
No use of this parallel. You can write here test, then it will work as a parallel,
yeah,
execution. Okay. So let's see this. Chrome and this I is working, okay, but let's see, this code is not working properly, okay, because of this Firefox having a problem. I did not change this Firefox, this issue is coming, okay. So if just try with in your system if it is working or not, okay, just try. So one more concept is there, that is called parallel execution. So same code I have discussed here. So code is same, this code is, this is still executing. Some problem with Firefox, that's why it is still executing. So what is the meaning of parallel execution and what is the difference between? So parallel execution is achieved by the XML file. In XML file shoot tag, there is based on the tag called parallel. Is there parallel? So parallel tag by default is none. Okay, so what happened? If we will create this XML file, so this parallel tag, where is this parallel? Yes, this is by default it is not. So here we are achieving only cross browser testing, but someone will ask how to achieve this parallel execution, what you have to do here, you have to pass parallel equal to tests. So what happened? Cross browser means it will execute one browser, it will open and close. But parallel means it will execute parallelly. Okay, it will execute parallelly at a time, all the browser will open and close. So this is called only parallel execution, cross browser testing, grouping execution, batch execution, parallel execution, all are important. So you have to do the practice with code, not with theory only. Okay, because of interview purpose, working purpose, you will get this code on Google also. Okay, no problem at all. So interview purpose, you have to do the practice. So just make it your tests. Okay, that's it. This is called your parallel execution. I will send you this code, try to fix. Okay, take the help of Google also if you are not able to do. Okay, just try. Okay, so this is your grouping execution, parallel execution, or batch execution, or cross browser. So these are the very important. Now for interview purpose, they will ask what is the difference between cross browser and parallel execution, what is the grouping execution, what is the batch execution. We have one more concept that is called assert. So assert means we have inside this we have a multiple methods. So assert equal, assert not equal, assert true, assert false, assert null, assert not null, assert same, assert not same. So we'll discuss with this code, what is the meaning of this assert a script. We have this assert. It's not there. Assert a script. Okay. So just I will understand what is the meaning of assert is a class. Okay. Which class it is? Because all the method are static here. Because we can call by using this assert dot method name directly, right? Class name dot, we are calling this. So all the methods are a static method inside this assert. So you can see assert equals. So equals means if you will pass both values, both value same, then it will pass. But I have passed 12 and 13. So that's why it is failed. You can see assert equals. Again I am using assert equals hi hello, it is fail because the both value are not same. Again I am using this assert equals, so I am passing both values same. So where we will use this? When you have to verify actual or expected condition. In real time we are using only this for verifying this. Okay, so you have to verify login page is displayed or not. When if you are enter email ID or password and you login page, then you have to verify home page is displayed or not. So how to do this? By using this assert we can do. Okay, so I will use in this framework also this assert equals. Okay, so we have a assert true. True means it will always true value. If you will have a false value, it will get failed. I'm passing this true, it will pass. Means our test case is false. You can see assert true, false. False means it will fail. We have a again one, you know, I took assert a string Mohit, assert equals name dot contains Mohit and name are false. So it will compare this name here. If it will fail, then name are false, means it this message will display. So these are the important methods which are using in the, you know, writing the test script. So when I am going to execute this, so let's see the output. Okay, so here 1 to 5 is fail. So 1, there is 1. Yes, it is failed because of both are different. 2 is also failed and 5 is also failed because this is false. So we'll, if you will go in the console, you will see this So 3 is pass, 4 is pass, and this 6 is pass. Test case 1 is fail. Why it is fail? Expected is 13, but we are getting 12. You can see again it is pass, fail because of expected is hello, you are getting high. Again it is failed. Why it is failed? Because expected is true but getting false. So how to compare this? Okay, so this is your assert.